I started cycling out of actually my lowest point of energy level that I had in my life so far. I'm basically doing what I love. I shoot, I take pictures, and I cycle. And yeah, that's it. My name is Katrin. I am a full-time freelance photographer. I'm trying to mix different styles in photography, so bringing different things together, like fashion things, sport things, and the combination of all of this is kind of what I do.
No car yet. This is today. So, Semonzo del Grappa.
I just got it from my dad, I think, because he taught me photography from when I was little. The whole passion really comes from that, I think. Actually, Flo, my husband, started cycling way earlier than I did, and he always tried to get me into that sport. But in the beginning, I was not really thinking that this could be a sport for me. In my opinion, it was always fast and dangerous. And at one point, I started cycling out of actually my lowest point of energy level that I had in my life so far. I was really pushing hard into the whole photography thing, and being a freelancer is not really easy. Yeah, I was at a point where I just threw in so much energy that my energy level was really low, and I was really at a, how do you say, breakdown point. And I was looking for something that could get me out of that. And one day it was just a decision to start cycling. And it was actually love at first sight. Being in the nature, riding, feeling free and being exhausted, but at the same time, it's like meditation also. That was kind of a starting point for me to get into the cycling photography thing without really planning it.
So good to have a support car.
There were not so many photographers out there, or at least I didn't see so much cycling photography that was a bit different from the sports photography thing that the normal sports photographers did. What makes me excited is to kind of cover moments that are not seen by everyone. So the hidden little moments and emotions.
Fantastic! Yes, fantastic! Very nice! Very beautiful! Really cool. Kaput! Uri! Kaput! In Galibier! Galibier! 9 minutes! You are there! Gavia! Gavia!
Ah, that's you!
In the gear, where are you? Cool. Kaput! In Durango!
But you have to see them, and you as a photographer have to be on point to not miss it, and to see the moment and to capture it.
You live here?
No. You do Bassano.
Wow.
The cool thing was when we were riding in the team car of the Katusha team, you could just go anywhere and just wave out of the window, and people got crazy. We were riding up the mountains and like, hey! And I was there with the camera, and that was just the best shots because everybody was waving back or.
Normally I check out the route by bike, which is always the best option actually, because then you exactly know what it looks like, where you can go to shoot, which angles are great. But sometimes you just have to take it as it comes.
Are they closing it or? So.
But then you are riding.
There are many things that have to come together. It's kind of a mixture of being there, getting the right angle, getting emotions or cool moments. Also at a race, like you go there, you try to capture the race in a different style, different angles, which is not easy always because you go there and you try to check out different spots from where you can shoot.
It's quite cool. You can see them coming from there and then you can run around up there to get the hairpin and maybe here some good shots with the guys.
It happens that you keep running around like crazy, like you can't decide from which angle or from which point of view you want to shoot the race because there are so many great spots. Then you have people standing around. It's just craziness. I think I would never shoot cycling without cycling myself. It's about so many things, and you have to understand the sports. You have to know what it's about, and yeah, you also have to know how a cyclist rides up a road, where he leans in, how do they ride a turn, so many other things. Normally I like to capture different things. I like to capture the cyclist in a great movement, like suffering, or like really that you can see the muscles, that you can see sweat, or that you can just see emotion. To call myself satisfied with a shoot. In the beginning you have pictures in your mind, but to get that shot is sometimes so hard. Some things you can influence and some things you can't.
Going down again.
All in all, I'm just happy when I look back at the day, when it was a great day, when I know I captured some great emotions or great spots or great sceneries. I'm happy about every day I'm out there shooting great cyclists or great racers.